Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel Nursery to Varsity. In this video, we are going to talk about the ethical as well as the unethical ways of going in SEO. So let us discuss what is unethical SEO as well as the ethical SEO. So in unethical SEO, it looks for the weaknesses and loopholes in search engine algorithms which are in direct conflict with their guidelines. So basically in unethical SEO, it can be considered as an illegal activity or an activity which is not accepted within the guidelines of the SEO. Examples of unethical SEO are link spamming, keyword stuffing, cloaking, hidden text and hidden links. And it majorly focuses on the quicker and unpredictable results which provide us the short-term existing growth. We cannot rely on unethical SEO for long-term growth. It provides us results instantly, but it is not the way of going ethically. On the other hand, let us discuss about the ethical SEO. It uses the optimal techniques and methods to improve the rankings as well as increase the traffic on the website. So the ethical SEO are using the techniques that are clearly visible to a website visitor, right? A website visitor is able to analyze what could have been the possible changes that the website developer must have been taken. Examples under the ethical SEO can be SEO optimized content, the link acquisition, or the keyword analysis. So unlikely the unethical SEO, in ethical SEO, it provides steady, gradual, but lasting growth results. So basically, it is taking more time than the unethical SEO, but it provides better, genuine, and long-lasting growth in the rankings. So let us discuss the ethical SEO in more depth. So what is an ethical SEO? The SEO performed within the ethically accepted code of conduct. Now this code of conduct can be considered as certain guidelines or certain policies which the search engines set for themselves, and according to those only we have to optimize our websites. It is also known as white hat SEO, like in the hacking terms we talk about the white hat hacking and the black hat hacking. The same way we are talking about white hat SEO. The second point says that these include the techniques that are visible to any public user of your website. Now, as I mentioned, suppose one user has visited your website before and now he can see those changes which you have made on your website for the SEO thing. So these are the changes which are visible to any public user of your website. The third thing is takes longer time but shows the results steadily. As I said, it takes a longer time, but it shows the gradual results which will help in the long-lasting growth of the rankings. Organic and ethical SEO is mostly free of cost. That is, if we exclude the part of the search engine marketing, mostly the organic traffic reaching and the on-page optimization according to the SEO guidelines is mostly free of cost. Unless you are taking the support of some free online tools, the paid version of those tools, or any other SEO developer. Now some of the major practices followed in ethical SEO are different links for separate web pages. Now this is a standard convention followed for any website development. We provide separate links for different web pages. Then making SEO optimized content that is keyword rich and providing quality content to the audience. Now we always have to ensure that whatever content we are producing out of our website, it always has to be SEO optimized in order to achieve better rankings. We have discussed a lot about SEO optimized content in my previous videos. You can check them out. I've told over there about the keyword richness and how to provide the quality content to the audience. The next thing is the inbound links and the backlinks through other popular websites that are high quality and well ranked. Again, I have discussed the concept of backlinks in my previous videos. In short, I can tell you that basically whenever we receive some links from the popular websites which are already high quality and well ranked, if we receive the links from those websites, they are generated as good backlinks and they are being considered by the search engines in the order of ranking. Then comes the ensuring of freshness of the content. This is also very important. It is not as prioritized in the SEO, but the freshness is also a metric that is considered in the ranking of results. Then using the sitemaps and robots.txt, again you can discuss them more in my previous videos. I have explained them better over there. and also using free online SEO tools such as the Page Speed Insights and so many more. So if you notice, whatever techniques we have used in this course are mostly based on the ethical SEO, and I am only covering the part of the ethical SEO. We don't need to practice the things of the unethical SEO because it is not the way of going. It is not recommended by most of the search engines. So try to stick your campaign mostly the ethical way. Let us gather some information about the unethical SEO as well. It is often referred to as the black hat SEO, making use of manipulative and sneaky techniques to rank up in results. So basically, as we discussed in the unethical SEO, what they try to do is they find the loopholes in the algorithms and then try to find those manipulative and sneaky techniques and apply them in those algorithms to rank up in the results. The second point says that mostly used by spammy websites or the ones which have a lot of irrelevant content. Now let us see it this way. Suppose you are making a website that generates a lot of links to some irrelevant or inappropriate websites. Now what you do is you have produced a lot of irrelevant content in it, but you have used those manipulative and sneaky techniques such as the keyword stuffing or say cloaking. What you are trying to generate a good amount of traffic for that website. So it is not the ethical way of going, and it is not recommended by most of the search engines. Then once the search engine detects these, the website is highly penalized and as a result could be blocked or removed from top rankings. Now what happens is whenever a search engine algorithm detects such activities, these websites are highly penalized according to their scores, and they can be either blocked according to the complaints received or also removed from the top rankings. Then it tends to provide immediate results in a short term, but usually not reliable at all. Let's say you have ranked on the first position for 2 or 3 days, but now it has been detected by the search engines and now you have been either blocked or you have been just removed from the top rankings. So you can never rely on unethical practices in SEO. You can never rely in such a way that you'll always be able to rank on the top using such practices. Now some of the major practices followed under unethical SEO are using hidden text, basically using those text smartly, like giving a white text under the white background so that nobody can see it, or behind the images to target the potential keywords. Basically this hidden text consists of the potential keywords and they try to rank it on those without showing them to the public users. Then the inner or external linking to web pages in a way that doesn't appear easily to the users. Basically do not showing the links directly, coloring the same way as the normal text is. So these techniques are also used. Then comes the cloaking and keyword stuffing, as we have discussed before. Then using misleading redirects by showing attractive pop-ups or offers that usually head towards spammy content. Now you will be able to see a lot of websites such as some movie downloading websites or any other websites which try to redirect you to some spammy website or some ads website. So once it is being detected by the search engines, you are surely going to see a lot of reduction in your organic traffic. Then also using the duplicate or copyright content to generate more traffic. Basically you are trying to copy the content of someone who has produced a rich quality content and then trying to add it on your own website to attract the audience. That is also an unethical practice. Then using the auto-generated content for high keyword density. Now this business of generating the auto content, basically there are a lot of free tools and also some paid tools which are giving you high keyword density content. Now the algorithms are getting better and better to detect these contents and they are blocking all of those. So always try to avoid black hat SEO practices as much as possible. Try to focus more on the steady results rather than the instant results. So this is all for today's video. Thanks for watching. Please stay tuned with us and like, share and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon. If you have any other queries, you can mail to us at nerdtour@gmail.com. Thank you.